Welcome back, viewers. Well, it's not just along the line of actual control that China seems to be provoking India again and again. It's also now news emerging that they may be attempting to attack and target India, Indian government ministries, Indian organizations, corporates and media houses via cyber warfare. Yes. In fact, there is news that's emerged that within the dark web, there are quite a few of these Chinese hacker groups where chatter has been picked up and conversations are about targeting Indian institutions. And this, viewers, the Times Network has learned, has come just a couple of days after the government really put out an advisory. And you may have seen this advisory because almost all corporates are sharing this amongst their employees. Banks have begun to put this warning out that if you're actually getting an email which talks about a free corona testing or sampling, don't fall for that email. It's actually a phishing attack. Just to understand all of this and really what is it that you and I need to do and be wary of, we've got Mr. Pawan Duggal joining us this evening. Thank you, Mr. Duggal. Well, for a layman to really understand this and to prepare ourselves, what is it that we are watching out for?
Well, we have to be watching out for a new play in cyberspace where all of us are potentially going to be made targets. Well, the best way is in this entire coronavirus age, when there is fear and panic all across, the best way to go ahead and weaponize this is by cyber criminals targeting us by cyber crimes like phishing. And because we are constantly in the search for new news, for new infection growth rates, that we are going ahead and clicking anything that comes in front of us. So trying to understand that basic human weakness, these phishing attacks are going to be targeting individuals, targeting organizations. And given the fact that Indian testing has not been really what it should be, once you are going to give such a wonderful offer of pre-COVID-19 testing, the chances are that 9 out of 10 Indians are likely to click on that. And once they click on that, they would be taken to another website, which could then be stealing all their information, their confidential data. Ultimate plan is to weaken the Indian ecosystem by getting all these people who will be clicking on these phishing kind of emails or messages as weak links in the broader cybersecurity chain of the country. So I think it's the first time in the history of independent India that India's nodal agency of cybersecurity has given this kind of a warning, and we now need to take it far more seriously.
Yes, in fact, you know, one would be obviously a little less concerned about the government institutions because we will assume that they have the best kind of a firewall, best kind of layers of security. Their own employees are well, you know, aware of it and trained. But corporate India, especially now, Mr. Duggal, where you know, a large percentage of people are working from home, accessing their work softwares, their emails, everything of home, does that make us more prone to this kind of an, you know, warfare strategy?
Surely. Suddenly, with Indians now coming onto the digital bandwagon and with this national lockdown telling us that, look, internet is the future, and majority of the Indians jumping onto the bandwagon without any adequate kind of sensitization or awareness, the chances of these Indians becoming victims of potential cybercrimes will keep on increasing. Already, when I look at the coronavirus age and specifically the lockdown experience, I've seen massive increase in cybercrime across the world, specifically in India, pertaining to phishing, identity theft and fraud. I've begun to see massive increases of cyber security breaches happening globally and also happening in India. In India, well, it's a different ballgame. Why? It's one of the biggest populations in the world. It's going to be one of the biggest e-commerce markets in the world. So what best for cyber criminals to go ahead and target this one of the biggest e-commerce markets by the cyber security vulnerabilities, considering that India is a very, very fertile target for this. India has chosen not to give the kind of importance to cybersecurity as we should have given. We don't have a dedicated law on cybersecurity. Our national cybersecurity policy of 2013 has remained a mere paper tiger. We have not been able to implement it. This at a time when a country like China has gone ahead in the last 3 years and has come up with 3 distinctive new national laws on cybersecurity. I think the time is that we need to learn from experiences of countries like Estonia in 2007 and Ukraine in 2016, that they could be potentially facing a huge cyber attack which could destabilize their economy. Let's not let history repeat ourselves in the context of India. And let's try to learn from the experience of other countries and try to beef up our cybersecurity to the best extent possible.
Well, I must say this, Mr. Dugal, you're the second, key expert on this issue that I've spoken with today, and both actually mentioned the same point that we need a stronger policy. It's largely been on paper and it's outdated as well. We need to update it, and I think that's something that the government should look at right now, considering the circumstances, and not just because we are currently in a standoff with China, or their hacker groups may be targeting us specifically, but also because as we go more digital, as we go more into era of larger work from home, dependence on technology and various devices increases, these are things that the country has to look at. Now, very quickly, let me tell you, viewers, ways to protect yourself: ensure that you are aware of the emails that you're opening. You know, if it's from an unknown name or an account with the weird header, don't just go right out and open that, especially when it comes to clicking on random links or downloading any attachments. Even if it says free COVID testing, don't open it. It might actually be a phishing attack. Also be, very careful of the links that you click on. If the link says something, take your mouse to it and hover around it and see if the text that appears again is actually the same. If it's a shortened link, then there may be something wrong with it. Pay very, very close attention for the emails that are punctuated with typos in them. That means that they may be fake and may be emerging from somebody who's targeting and looking for a way into your email account and then your device that you're actually using. Be wary of threats or urgent deadlines that are put out by companies, your insurance company, your bank company. Somebody could be pretending to do that. Right now is a time where this activity has been stepped up. So you need to be extra careful and read up on the softwares that you can actually use to protect all of your gadgets. Thank you for joining us on this conversation. Lots more on the other side of the 9 p.m. Urban Debate Edition. Stay with me.